ओम असतो मा सद्गमया तमसो मा ज्योतिर्गमया। दिस इज अ वेरी एंशियंट प्रेयर विच हैज बीन अडॉप्टेड बाय दिस इंस्टीट्यूशन इन देयर एम्ब्लेम। एम्ब्लेम शोज वट वी आर, वट वी शुड बिकम। We have been listening to different small lecture pieces, wonderfully constructed by the heads and eminent scholars. I am very much thankful to all of them. I was really listening to them, and many a good things has been told, which we must listen. Why? Because human being is something which is called in our national language, the ancient language, manushah. You know what is the meaning of manushah? In no other country, in no other country of the world, you will get this type of deepest rooting of everything what we have. Manushah means, it is said, mananat manushah. Who can think is a human being. Otherwise, they have simply equated human being with animals. Ahara nidra bhayumaitunancha samanyametat pashubhir naranam. Eating, sleeping, everything is exactly same as an animal do. Dharmo hi eka adhiko visheshaha. It is the sense of discrimination which is specially given to human being. Dharmena hina pashubhi samanaha. If you don't have that, you are an animal. Very short and clean description. As it was being said, 20% have succeeded to see the face of success. Rigorous study, wonderful dream, untiring commitment, struggle has brought you to the stage of success. Yes, you were successfully dissipated from this institution as a responsible citizen. But that success is a very small term, planned struggle of our life. May not be a part of our life. It's a very small part of our life. The whole life is in front of you. Not only students, for anybody who has not passed away yet. So wonderfully said by Manush Babu, wonderfully, that success is a journey, but the goal is livelihood or liveliness. Let me tell you the secret of life. Because there have been a series of successful people who are absolutely failure in life, and so-called many failures who have shown what success is in life. Life is not just. Life will not give you rest. Life is not exactly a match paper of your dream. Let me tell you one small couplet, very old wisdom. You see, if you go to the wisdom what we had as our ancestors have, it is wonderful. This says one wonderful thing. Amantram aksharam nasti. There is no single word which cannot be used as a mantra. amantram aksharam nasti nasti moolam anushadham. In the days of Kaviraji and all these things, Ayurveda, it's not coming up branch, they found not a single root which is not usable. Everything is usable. To whom? Who can use it? 3. Ayogyo manavo nasti. There is not a single man who is non-eligible. It is rather, to tell it in perfect perspective, yet perhaps we have not been able to put up a right institution who can really turn these words to fact. The most important truth you have to learn, whoever you are, be a student or a scholar or a teacher, whoever, that is one small thing. What Swami Vivekananda used to say repeatedly, whole life he said, each soul is potentially divine. First thing, let me be very frank and fair with you. Never, never belittle yourself. Please don't do that. In a little more complicated way to state, don't become successful to show that you are not a failure. Don't struggle and die inside with a presumption of failure. Please don't do that. And on the other part of the story, when you say, yes, I can do everything, Swamiji used to say, always say to yourself, I can do anything and everything. It is true. So always be positive with yourself first. It comes from you. And you know, the basic prerequisite of doing a good to you is think that you are good first. In spite of the thorns, you may have a rose bud just hidden inside, waiting to bloom if nourished properly. So don't see at the thorns of the rose tree. You have a rose inside. Always remember that. And as an extension of this rose, let me tell you, all of you are flowers of different variety. He may be a rose, she may be a marigold, that fellow may be something else. So, because of this internal, inner and imprinted difference, please, please, please don't compare with others. Don't compare a rose with a marigold. Don't compete with a marigold being a rose. What to do? Please compete with yourself. If you nourish the tree properly with water, manure, care, what will happen, you know? The same rose tree will give the best of the rose it can give to the society. If you don't do that, it will be a worm-eaten, small, bad, unusable rose. You being a rose tree, compete with yourself. Have I been able to do what could I have done? You do compete every moment with your possibilities and what endeavor you are putting into it. You cannot compete with others. This is the value I learned in my school of medicine. One of my professors told me this one. And it has changed my life. There is nothing to compete with outside. It's all a dream land you construct in the air and you die in that small castle. It is you will struggle with your potentials and mind it, you are potentially perfect and divine. You can manifest what you have and you cannot do what you don't have. Don't struggle to incorporate things, to design and keep things what you cannot preserve. So the couplet comes like that, what I was telling: amantram aksharam nasti, nasti moolam anushadham, ayogyo manavo nasti, then yojakaha tatra durlabha. Who will nourish these potentials to its fullest of manifestation is rare. So here comes the institution, the faculties, the teachers, and that is everything. We used to say acharyo devo bhava, along with father and mother, which value has been told by one of the faculties. Pitrudevo bhava, matrudevo bhava, then comes acharyo devo bhava. It's not just snatch something from somebody and lock it in your personal locker. Don't do that. The more you give knowledge, the more wise you become. More you collect information, we say, more knowledgeable you become. But knowledge will not give you peace. Wisdom will give you peace. So disseminate knowledge. You know, another small value I'll just tell you, very important and pertinent. In a class you will see, a rule will be there, somebody make disturbance and all, teacher will come, they will punish because they cannot find who is the culprit. All and everybody will be put to kneel down and all these things. But one person have done something wrong, others have not done. That fellow was boasting, bullying, and he did all the mischief. So when all were standing in a punishment posture, the teacher came and told, did you do the problem? No, sir. You? No, sir. You? I am a very good boy, sir. I did not do. So there are so many goody boys. Really, they have not committed. But see the condition. Is it the condition of a good boy? Simply getting slap and punishments, still keeping quiet, without telling anything. Is it the value he is practicing? So one of our presidents, Swami Ranganathan, used to say one nice thing. The problem caused in the class was by an active bad boy. He was active. He were good. Then he used to call, was there not a single active good boy who could have slapped him and make him sit and save all the good boys? We need active goodness, not passive goodness. Goody boys will not do now. If you have real power of goodness, why don't you stand up? Why don't you be bold? Why don't you walk erect? You should not be afraid of anybody. That is the power of goodness. You need not advertise yourself. You need not go to take recourse of anybody. You yourself is sufficient to stand and face everybody. Let us not only be successful, but be wise, be strong, be courageous, be moral. Morality is not a small thing that you may inculcate and get a name of a good boy in the society. It is a need. You know, who are aware of the society nowadays? Just he was telling what it has seen in last 5 years or say 12 years, it has not seen in last 2000 years. It is so true. There is now a face-to-face sort of a tussle, challenge, inquiry, vigilance from all corners. Whatever service you give, they are facing each other in a small room. And the media is there, everything is there. And all the sectors have its good part, bad part, good boys, corrupted boys. Swami Vivekananda used to say, it is character which cleaves its path through the adamantine walls of adversities. If you don't have character, my dear boys, that will really tell upon your whole life. with big degrees, you may be a big failure in life. I have seen a first boy who used to get first in every class. He became second in one class. The next day he was not found in the school. He was searching in the home. So he was found dead, hanging from the wall, because he could not succeed becoming first boy. Do you think, is it a success in life? It is not a success in life. Life is a struggle, but struggle with your own innate internal weapon of morality and character. And let me tell you, if you be a man of character, you know, to become bad, you may take 7 years to learn a bad things to do. But to become a man of character, if you really struggle that much, what you did in becoming a bad boy, it will take 1 month. Practice something solid, good, what you can become, you think. For 1 month, see, the fragrance of goodness in you will come out. Everybody has a very, very good internal treasure. And it is, I can say, a failure on the part of institutions, on the part of industries, policies, that we are not being able to utilize human resource in its fullest. What to speak of fullest, even the minimum. And third and last point, you have other small qualities. You think, I sing, what is there to sing? Rather, I should go and earn some money. I play football, as he used to play football. Might be he is now engaged in here, but still, he is very much sportsman. Sportsman spirit he has imbibed from sports is the highest spirit he has imbibed, I should say. And don't let these faculties go in vain. Please do keep connected with these faculties. This may not be acknowledged. These are not given price. But don't calculate anything and everything with price. Just think of yourself. How far study matters in your life or in your character? Very, very less. You have studied something, you have got some degree. How much contains in your life, whole life? Very less portion. You have friends, you have circles, you have chit-chats, you have hobbies, entertainments. That is why when the examination is finished, all are happy. Why? Unnecessary burden has gone away. I am now with my own self. I am very happy. This was unnecessary. Hurled upon me, somehow I was carrying. They call me successful. Thank you for success. But it is not my life. Be very careful with your life. Always get and keep rooted from your life where you really get sap of your life. You know, in Gita, one wonderful statement is there. Prasade sarvadukhanam hanihi asya upajayate. Prasad means satisfaction of the mind, prasannata. Sarvadukhanam, whatever misery you have, if you have got a taste of real goodness and peace and joy of your mind, sarvadukhanam hani, it really crushes, evaporates all the sufferings and misery in you. It must be that good quality things. Suppose some of you sing or paint or write something. When you were passing through a bad dark phase of your life, if you have really excelled in that area of, say, singing or whatever, if you can really go deep down to that thing, everybody feels a lot of peace and pleasure. He can forget the whole world. That is much more costly than all the buildings and cars and fixed deposits put together. It is not valued. It is not told to you. It is not included in your curriculum. It is not necessary in corporate life. But life is yours. You don't get corporated in corporate lives. It is your life you have to handle. So connected with your own potentials. Don't disbelieve in yourself. If you don't disbelieve in yourself, you cannot mistrust others also. Your friendship, your goodness, your happiness, joy will automatically emanate from you. All will come in your area, will be joyful, happy, and help everybody and anybody comes in your area. That is the only dharma. Only dharma in this era. Parapukaraya punyaya papaya parapiranam. If you really torture others in any means, that is papa, if at all papa is there. Why? That will come back to you and make you suffer equally. Don't do it consciously. And help anybody and everybody who comes in your path. I tell you, that is the highest pleasure, highest punya, highest dharma. That is dharma. Whoever comes in front of me, whoever I see, I will do my best to him. I tell you, this treasure of pleasure and satisfaction, happiness will be with you till you breathe your last in the hospital or a bed alone, lying down. We came alone, we'll go alone. This will be the treasure. Not a single bank balance, not a single building or car will go with me. So with these few words of values, I think, let us all begin and advance forward. Don't look back. Huh? If some shortcomings comes, don't look back. Chariveti, go forward, forward. They say, God has given me eyes in front, not in back. He is intelligent. He thinks us to see in front. Don't look back. See front, go ahead with courage, positivity, help, and satisfaction. First you, then everybody. Thank you.